11.20 is the review of prior year audit report and management report. We did an audit last year, or somebody did an audit last year, hopefully, and you've got the prior financial statements in front of you. Whether it is you or another auditor, there is an audit report. And what we're trying to glean on this document, 11.20, is are there matters from the previous year that are significant enough that I need to carry them over to this year? So we go and have a look at what type of audit opinion was issued in the previous year. Did we have an unmodified opinion, an emphasis of matter, adverse, disclaimer, or qualified? So go and have a look at the audit report and the financials in the prior year. Hopefully you're saying unmodified. Then we don't really need to do too much about the report itself. But if we say there's an emphasis of matter, we need to go and describe the reason for the modification. So go and have a look at that emphasis of matter paragraph. What were we saying? Was it saying that property, plant, and equipment was not impaired correctly? Is it saying that stock was overvalued? What is sitting in the emphasis of matter? And based on that, we can say, are there risks that we're identifying based on the report from the previous year? If we say yes, you'll see that the risk description block becomes green, and we can now once again go and document the risk that you're identifying here in this case, 11.20. And once again, we need to go and look, is it a fraud risk or a business risk that we're dealing with here? Okay. I didn't mention it earlier, but remembering that the difference between fraud and business risks involves management intent. Where management intentionally is trying to misstate or misappropriate assets, then we're dealing with a fraud risk. Otherwise, we're dealing with a business risk. Generally, is it error, like stock theft in a retail outlet? That's a business risk. It's going to happen. It's not management trying to steal it, unless you can actually prove that management is busy stealing the stock, then obviously we're going to deal with it as a fraud risk, but otherwise it is a business risk. Further down, we then also ask to go and have a look at the management report issued in the prior year. And that again could be your management report or the management report of a previous auditor. And firstly, is there actually a management report, yes or no? As soon as you say yes, we go and document what are the issues that were raised in that management report, a summary of management's response to the management report. That can sometimes be documented in the report itself. Sometimes you actually need to discuss with management and say, listen, it was telling us here that there was a poor segregation of duties in the creditors section of your company. What have you done about it? Well, nothing. Well, then we document that, and basically we know that there's already a risk. So we can already go and describe the risk. So is there a continuing risk? Yes or no? If yes, describe the risk. Okay, segregation, duties, and once again, is that a business or a fraud risk? Okay. Once again, just importance, I'm summarizing these risks for training purposes. Please don't put one or two words in here. It is helpful to rather describe that risk in full so that when we get to the risk register, we know what we're talking about. One of the advantages that I've felt in relation to the risk identification process in RAC is that the risk is being documented on the working paper itself rather than in just in the separate risk register. So as you're reading through from a planning, from a review point of view, as you're reading through the planning section, you can see the issues, the information that's documented, and the risk that's being raised side by side without having to jump between various documents to go and identify it. So please do document these risks in enough detail so that you're not at the end of the day left guessing what does this risk actually mean. Okay. So 11.20, looking at the report and audit report and the management report issued.